Texicana Barbecue.
Today we are in Houston, Texas at Harlem Road BBQ, owned by a good friend of mine and great chef, Ara Malakian. Ara really has a rockstar barbecue kind of lifestyle. In a few words, it's basically the barbecue version of Chuck Norris. But today we are here to take a look at some very interesting smoker called PitMaker. I'm gonna leave the link in the description, pitmaker.com. PitMaker makes a large variety of smoker. This specific one is a cabinet smoker and it's called the BBQ Vault. At the bottom there is a drawer where the charcoal goes. The way Chef Ara positioned the charcoal is very interesting. He does like a snake shape, so the charcoal will burn slowly and evenly through the cook. And by the time you get at the end of the snake, the brisket will be ready. This smoker is so efficient that it takes a little more than a quarter bag of charcoal to run the whole brisket cook. And to make the smoke more interesting, Chef Ara placed on top of the snake a few pieces of French oak wine barrels. The smoke from the bottom is channeled from the side and the back through the smokestack on top. That allowed the smoke to move quickly to the top and avoiding oversmoking the meat. It's also extremely well insulated. The door and all the panels around are 2 inches. There are 4 racks inside the smoker that can fit 3 brisket each. And if you consider that the smoker is only 24 inch deep, 49 inch high, and 32 inch wide, that's pretty impressive. In other words, 2 PitMaker Vaults, they have the same capacity of 1000 gallon offset smoker. But check this out, the ideal maximum capacity of a 1000 gallon offset smoker is 24 brisket, 6 rows of 4 brisket ideally. Instead, the ideal maximum capacity of 1 PitMaker BBQ Vault is 12 brisket. But if you get 2, the capacity will be 24 brisket. On average, a 1000 gallon offset smoker is long between 19 and 21 feet. PitMaker BBQ Vault, together, they're gonna be a little more than 8 feet. 1 PitMaker Vault will cost $4,000. 2 PitMaker, $8,000. 1000 gallon offset smoker always gonna be more than that. The PitMaker Vault, it only needs a quarter bag of charcoal to run a full brisket cook. With a 1000 gallon offset smoker, you can't even start the cook. Good luck with that. The BBQ Vault, it also cooks much faster than an offset smoker. It is mainly because of the great insulation of the smoker. The cooking chamber seals so well that if you try to close the door with the smokestack shut, the door will never close. You are forced to open the firebox. But now let's have a chat with Chef Ara that cooks every day with this smoker, but only after trying some damn good smoke tri-tip.
So I do my briskets in 2 batches.
Okay.
So the first batch comes out at 5 a.m. Second batch comes out around 11:12.
Gotcha. So you prefer to do two cooks instead of one big one?
Yeah, because that way I don't have to hold it way too long.
Exactly. Because then no matter how good you cook, and when you hold it, oxidizes a little bit, you know.
Yeah.
It tends to.
Like what I do is I wrap it in butcher paper, let it rest. I don't wrap my briskets when they're inside.
Ah, you don't?
No,
oh, you go naked all the way.
Smoker,
in this smoker, that's make no
you
sense.
You don't have to wrap them all the way.
Gotcha.
To finish them off. Because it gets a beautiful bark as it is. There is no stall because of the efficiency of the smoker.
Oh, the smoker.
So it takes 8 hours.
About 8 hours.
Yeah, about 8 hours.
And a lot of people with cabinet smoker, they have a problem of setting the bark. Because the cooking chamber gets very wet most of the time, you know. Oh, even if they're big, you know, actually the bigger they are, the more trouble they have.
Yeah.
What about with the pit maker?
I've not had an issue with the pit makers because I run them in a lower temperature. They run very nice. I never have to spray the meat because it doesn't dry out. Okay, so because of the way it's designed and
exactly.
How well the airflow on it is, it doesn't build too much moisture. It's actually the opposite.
And Ara, in your cook, do you keep you tend most likely now then you know the tendency is like you start slow with the I'm talking about the offset and then you start ramping, you know, toward the end of the cook. Do you keep a constant temperature? Do you ramp?
So what I do is I start with a higher temperature. So
okay.
I heat up the chamber with a blowtorch to 350 degrees, I load it up.
You like the blowtorch, don't you?
Yeah. Well, I use that big blowtorch. So once I put all the meat in there, the meat is cold. So So it'll drop it down to 225, and then I'll try to maintain the temperature no higher than 235 the entire time.
Okay,
on
so
on brisket.
What about pork ribs? And how long will it take you to cook to go through all the cook with pork ribs?
3 hours total.
3 hours total. That's fast.
Yeah.
That's fast. And you don't wrap pork ribs either.
No. Once it's fully done and it's got a nice bark and a nice color on it, I wrap them in foil, and then they go in the hot box.
And now, after a nice cowboy hot coffee, we're basically ready to go. Thank you, Ara, for your time. That'll be all for today. I'm going to leave PitMaker and the Harlem Road website down below in the description. What do you prefer? The PitMaker BBQ Vault or the Offset Smoker? Let me know below in the comment section. You can follow me on Instagram and Facebook as Texicana BBQ. If you want to see more of this video, please support my channel by subscribing. Ciao!